Shalom, everyone. This is the Word of Truth Ministry. Glad to have you back on the YouTube channel. Amen. Getting ready to go down through the Word of God for you. Amen. If you have friends, enemies, the devil, give to them. Word of Truth Ministry, YouTube channel. Amen. Today, we're going to come from the book of Luke. And let's deal with the lost and found section. Amen. In this book, it's talk about the lost sheep, the lost corn, and the lost son. We're going to deal with the lost son, which they say is the prodigal son. In that case, you got some prodigal daughters. So we're going to be talking about you too, women of God. That's what it says here. Luke 15 and 11, what it say?
And he said, a certain man had two sons.
He did.
And the younger of them said to his father,
yeah,
Father, give me the portion of good that falleth to me. And he divided unto them his living.
Look what it says here in the lost and found section. It said a certain man has two sons. And the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of good that falleth to me. And he divided unto them his living. Brothers and sisters out there, it's a bad thing to be lost. Now, I'm a lot of things and don't have a lot of things. Might not be rich, wealthy, might not be an intelligent man that you know. But one thing is, I'm not lost. It's a terrible thing when you're lost. It's a story that has been said around. I don't know how true it is. But it was saying that this man ran across a young boy. He was out there playing. Amen. He passing through. He's trying to get downtown, whatever downtown you want to call it. And he stopped and he said, young boy, I'm trying to get downtown. Can you show me how to get downtown? He said, yeah. Go down, take a left, take a right, and keep straight. Man went down there, took the left, took a right, kept straight, and still was lost. Came back and made a loop. And found the young boy again. This young man, I told you I want to go downtown. He said, I told you, take a left, take a right, keep straight. Try it again, still we're lost. So the young man, come back around, and he pulled over, and this time he say, young man, you about the dumbest old young boy I ever seen in my life. And the young boy stopped playing, looked up at the man, he said, I might be the dumbest you ever seen, but I ain't lost. Come on, him. It's a bad and a terrible thing to be lost. And it always been said, amen. If you don't know where you're going, any road will take you there. Here, the young man is called the lost son. Young man said to his father. Now, the young man here, it said he didn't lie to his father. He didn't beg. He didn't steal. He didn't do all that. He was a good young man. You never find out where he did anything else bad when he was with his father. And the thing about it is, he said, give me my portion. He asked for what he wanted. He didn't steal it. He didn't beg for it. He just said, Father, what belongs to me, let me have mine. He asked for it. And this is what we ought to be out there. Matthew 7 and 7 say, ask and it shall be given. Seek and it shall find. Knock and it shall be opened. Ask for what you want from God. Amen. And most of the time, 9 to 10 rule, you might still be able to get what you're asking for. Continue. 13th verse says,
and not many days after the youngest son gathered all together and took his journey into a far country, and there wasted his substance with riotous living.
He lived a riotous life. Stayed in the nightclub. Stayed in the strip club. And if it's your daughter, you might have been one of the strippers. Come on. You done got lost. Amen. What are you addressing nice now? Amen. You dressing provocative. Lost. And here is a good thing you're looking at here. It went into a far country. Amen. The man or the young man had more respect for his father till he went way out and did his dirt. He didn't do it right at home. He said, went into a far far country and did his righteous living. Don't do all your dirt if you're going to do dirt around your family, around mama, around daddy, if you decide to run off into righteous living. Smoking, drinking, doing whatever you want to do. Go way off from your family and do it, if you decide to do it. Lost son, lost daughter. 14 verse says, what?
And when he had spent all, there arose a mighty famine in that land, and he began to be in want.
Now, brothers and sisters, the elders always used to say, rainy day is coming. If you don't save your money, you don't put back what you have, you're going to come to want. If you're a wasteful person, talking to my young people now, amen. If I got some middle-aged people, talking to you too. Don't go into a righteous living like you, amen, like money that's falling out the sky, growing on trees. Because if it is, you're going to come to want. The young man found out, amen, after he done balled out, making it rain in every nightclub, setting the table for everybody. Now he become the want. What the 15th verse says?
And he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country.
Yeah.
And he sent him into his fields to feed swine.
Now you get to the point where you're down and out. You're accepted enough to live any kind of way. Now this man here is getting ready to be out with the hogs. Why? Because his righteous living, his bowling and all that, setting the table for all his partners. Now he's at the bottom of the bar. He had a righteous living. Because he had lost. 16 verse says,
And he would fain have filled his belly with the husks that the swine did eat, and no man gave unto him.
You get so low that nobody gonna help you. At no point in time. Now he down there eating with the hogs. And we know hogs eat anything. This is why God told us in the word, amen. When you got nothing else to do, look it up. Leviticus 11, Deuteronomy 14. We are not supposed to eat no part of the hog. Not only eat with the hog, we don't supposed to eat the hog, period. But we got a lot of us out there, amen, eating all kinds of pork. We eat everything from the root to the tooth on the hog. Pig feet, pig ear, pig lip, pork chop, chitlins, skins. Come on now. God said, don't be eating of that. Because it's an abomination. It's not good for you. But we eat it. Why? Because we're lost. And brothers and sisters, I have you to know, anybody where you don't know who you are, where you come from, where your inheritance is, you're lost. Not only that you're lost, you are dead while you're living. This young man here done got lost. Now he's down to the point, amen, he's eating with the hog. That was swine here, it's hogs. And the 17th verse says what?
And when he came unto himself,
yeah,
he said,
uh-huh,
how many hired servants of my father's have bread enough to spare?
Yeah.
And I perish with hunger.
Brother and sister, it ought to come in a time in your life where some ought to click in your head to tell you, I need to get back to God. This is what this all is talking about. It's talking about a lost son and a lost daughter that has gotten away from God. Because when you look at, he went into a far country, that means he got away from his family. He got away from his father and doing this, balling out. In the spiritual sense, this man, young man, I'm putting the woman in there too, because we got daughters that got lost. You done got so far from God till in and everything goes. But here, when a young man come to himself, sometime, somewhere along the line, you ought to come to yourself and say, wait a minute. I've been living bad. I've been living rowdy. I've been doing everything under the sun. Let me get back to my father. This is spiritual here. Let me get back to him. Come to himself. Look what it said. And when he had came to himself. But the only way he came to himself is when he got to the lowest of lowest. He at the bottom of the barrel. And he said, wait a minute. My father is rich. My father is wealthy. And the God that we serve is truly a wealthy and rich God. Huh? He got everything. God said in the word that I got a cattle on 1,000 hills. Mm-hmm. And if I were hungry, I wouldn't ask you for nothing. The word of God said the earth and the fullness thereof belongs to God. So he got everything. What can you give God that got everything? What can you give your father that got everything? I know somebody out there saying, well, ain't nothing you can get. Oh, the devil's a liar. You tell him I said so. The most important thing that you can give the man that got everything, don't need nothing, is one word. Obedience. Now, how about that? That's what you can give God. Give him your obedience, meaning to obey. Oh, that's all you get. It don't cost you nothing. Just do it. Huh? You ain't got to steal, borrow, beg for it. Just do it. You don't have to work for it. Just do it. God said obedience is better than sacrifice. Just obey. And you got everything. Because God going to give you everything once you obey. Look out, man. Obedience was from the beginning. That's how Adam got messed up. Not being obedient. He disobeyed. All right here. 18th verse says,
I will arise and go to my father.
Look now.
And will say unto him,
what?
Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee.
That's all you got to do. Look out now. When you done got away from God, because you're lost, you ought to get up today that you hear this YouTube channel and say, Lord, my God, I done did everything under the sun. I want to get back to you. And the word is repent. Again? The word is repent. Repent to God. Say, Lord, I'm sorry. I done did a lot of stealing, robbing, amen. Adulteries, fornication, whatever it want to be. Whoremongering, amen. Prostitution, I don't care what it is. Just repent to him. Say, I've been lost. And you surely are lost when you do all those ungodly things. Come to yourself. Amen. And repent to God and let him receive you with open arms. He said, look here, he said, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee. What happened?
I will arise and go to my father, and I will say unto him,
yeah.
Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee, and am no more worthy to be called thy son.
Look now.
Make me as one of thy hired servants.
This young man said, I'm not trying to be next to you. I just want to be, like David said, amen. I just want to be a doorkeeper. This young man is high up on the list. His father is wealthy. His father got a lot of things. But he says, Father, I don't want to be called worthy of son anymore. Just let me be one of the highest servants. Just let me be amongst you, amen, in this kingdom of yours. What it says.
And he arose,
uh-huh.
And he came to his father.
What?
But when he was yet a great way off,
uh-huh.
His father saw him,
what?
And had compassion, and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him.
It's all about your repentance and returning home, returning back to God. Brothers and sisters, how long you been away from God? How long you been lost? How long you been out there doing what you want to do, when you want to do it? How long you been doing it? You hadn't come to yourself yet? Why does it take the corona to bring you back to God? Come on. Why it takes sickness, a friend's death, mother, uncle, ain't it? Something bad happened for you to return home. Why you can't just return home on your own? Amen. The man says here in the word of God says, the father saw his son coming, and he ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. God is happy when he sees his children returning home. Returning home mean what? Returning back to him. Being commandment keepers. 21 says,
and the son said unto him,
what did he say?
Father, I have sinned against heaven and in thy sight, and am no more worthy to be called thy son.
Come, Daniel.
But the father said unto his servant,
what?
Bring forth the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand and shoes on his feet, and bring hither the fatted calf and kill it, and let us eat and be merry. For this my son was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found, and they began to be merry.
God says it in his word that the young man admit when he was wrong, admitted that he had fell off. So when are you going to admit it? God said in the word in Jeremiah, read that when you got nothing to do, in Jeremiah 3. God said, only acknowledge your iniquity. Brother and sister, you got to take ownership when you're wrong. And once you take ownership when you're wrong, then God can work with you. Who took ownership? David. David, amen, when the prophet Nathan came to him and told him, say, David, I'm going to set a parable for you. And he set the parable for him. And David said, that man should surely die. And the prophet said, David, you are that man. Then, oh, Lord, I have sinned. David took ownership of it. And once he took ownership of it, everything was well. You take ownership when you have left God, doing all this riotous living, and coming back to God. God said, I receive you with open arms. But you got to take ownership when you're wrong, and admit when you're wrong, and let us do away with that. And he says here, the man got the fattest calf and killed it. They're going to eat and be merry. He said, because my son was dead, now he's alive. He was lost, and he's found, and began to be merry. Read.
Now his elder son was in the field.
Yes.
And as he came and drew nigh to the house, he heard music and dancing. And he called one of the servants, and he asked, what these things meant.
What's all the dancing and what all the music that I hear going on? This is the elder son out there just working in the field. Amen. And the servant getting ready to tell him something. What? Now this is the good boy. They never did no wrong. Stayed right with his father. And he's still working at this time. What happened?
And he said unto him,
what?
Thy brother is come, and thy father hath killed the fatted calf, because he hath received him safe and sound. And he was so angry and would not go in. Therefore came his father out and entreated him.
He was angry, the oldest boy, because the father had received the younger boy. Why did he receive the younger boy? Because he has come home. And the elder is upset. Because what? Read.
And he answering said to his father, lo, these many years do I serve thee, neither transgressed I at any time thy commandment. And yet thou never gavest me a kid, that I might make merry with my friends.
Read.
But as soon as this thy son was come, which hath devoured thy living with harlots, thou hast killed for him the fatted calf.
The elder son got a good point. He said, now wait a minute. Father, I've been with you all this time. We've been working the field together. We've been doing this together. I haven't had a cross word with you. I haven't been disobedient to you. Everything you tell me to do, I did that. And not one time you thought it was right, amen, to kill a calf or a kid, amen, and throw me a birthday party, yada, 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 amen, and no time. And I got friends. You didn't have nothing for me. He got a point. But look how the father, amen, entreated his son. What did he say?
And he said unto him, son, thou art ever with me, and all that I have is thine.
Son, what you don't understand is everything I got belongs to you. I already got the will made out. Just because he came home, don't mean he's going to get part of this will. I'm not going to change the will. We know, amen, that he's been out there with the hogs. We know, amen, that he been living foul. We know he been a drunk, whoremonger, all that stuff, making it rain, partying, and all of that. I'm not going to change that. But I'm happy, amen, that he came home. Brothers and sisters, God is happy when any and everybody can turn around and get back to him. So, brothers and sisters, what this story is telling us is, if you right, stay right. God got something for you. It's already in the cards. It's already in the stars. It's already in the heaven. God got what's for you is for you. But if you've been living foul, living a little rowdiness, God said, I'm happy. The angels is happy. Everybody is overjoyed when you turn and get back to him. Because God don't want no soul to be lost. Whether it's black, white, or candy stripe, everybody, amen, God received with open arms if you get back to his commandment, his law, and his statutes. This is all God is talking about here. I don't want nobody to be lost. But if you keep going the way you're going, you're going to be lost and will never be found. Son, what I got for you, amen, it's not going to change. Read.
It was meet that we should make merry and be glad, for this thy brother was dead and is alive again and was lost and is found.
Everybody ought to be joyous and happy when one of God's precious daughters, son, has come back into the fold. Amen. When God sent in his word, if you got 100 sheep and one go astray, go find that one. And is overjoyed and rejoice when that one is found. That's what we're talking about, the lost and found. God don't want nobody to be lost, but he's not going to force you to be found. So brothers and sisters, I'm asking you, those of you who have gotten away from God, those of you, amen, have been so far, when it says in a far country, far country also can mean you have got farther away from God. Well, you need to get back close to God. It has been said through my great teacher, Rabbi Divine, he would say at many times, you don't got away from the fire. And the farther you get from the fire, the colder you get. The closer you get to the fire, the warmer you get. So get closer to God and keep getting warmer and warmer. God is saying here, come on back. Get back to me, my prodigal son, my prodigal daughter. Those of you that's going through these trials and tribulations at this time, those of you have put God aside because you allowed the virus to separate you from God. God said, now you got lost. Amen. And same way as I can continue to cover you and shield you from the virus, I can do that. But you're using it as an excuse not to worship me, not to come see me, not to inquire of me. God said, you're getting lost. You're getting further from me. Get back to me. And that, brothers and sisters, I say unto you, may God bless you and may God keep you. May his face continue to shine upon you and give you peace. And continue to look at the YouTube channel. Amen. If you like, subscribe. And on the click on the button and give us a thumb up. Or maybe you want to give me a 2 thumbs up. Give it 2. Brother and sister, may God bless you and keep you. And I greet you. Shalom.